right, yo, so we're actually having like a kind of a little Saturday ride, a weekend ride, meeting up with Brian. I don't know if I mentioned him in a previous video. Come on, you damn Mustang, jeez. What are all these packets? Little dominoes. Dominoes packets. Dude, these brakes. So touchy. I gotta, I still got my blinker on. Damn it. I'm really terrible about that. Still getting used to this thing. It's like a super nice day to be riding, yo. Alright, so before he gets here, I guess just some real quick stuff to go over. I'm testing out a new microphone. I've gone back to the Hero 5 Black. So, Super View with image stabilization, 1080p at 60 frames per second is what my settings are today. The mic I'm testing is, I can't remember the name. I mean, the name of it's right here. Here's a screenshot of it. So it's funny because a couple of you guys, like, I've done, I think I did like 3 or 4 Hero 5 Black, like, test videos. You know, the problem was always audio clipping. And so another motovlogger, I guess, ended up discovering a mic that works without the clipping. A couple of you guys, I want to say there was like three or four of you guys that posted up on one of my latest videos saying, yo, Blockhead, this guy found out a solution. Which, once again, having this community, you guys keeping that on your mind and coming back and letting me know, hugely, hugely appreciated. So, I mean, like, thank you guys so much. I really appreciate that, like, because I wouldn't have found it otherwise. I think I said that in a previous video as well, but, you know, like, I finally got the mic. That's what we're recording with right now. Hopefully it's not picking up too much on, like, my breathing and shit. What are you riding? Jigster. You know, it's funny. I really didn't know much about these bikes at all until I started researching wanting to buy one, and then, like, you just start to learn all the models, you know, but, like, all the little tiny things that, like, is different about them. So, granted, like, by no means am I an expert on them, but definitely researched it a lot. It was between the R6 and the CBR600RR. I always feel like saying that, like, Psycho Cruiser, CBR600RR. Because I know he's a big advocate for the bike, but I'm going to do a, kind of like I did with the Harley, with the Iron 883, I'm going to do a video of why I chose the Yamaha R6. And so you guys will basically gain a lot of my insight into why I went with it, my decisions behind getting a 600 and why the Yamaha versus the CBR versus a Ninja versus a Jigster. Because, I mean, a lot of very similar bikes, you know, that are like 600s right in there. So, anyways, back to the mic stuff. Pretty much today is kind of, it's like a brand new Hero 5 mic test run. So, hopefully, this previous Motovloggers, he's flogging. Flogging Moto. I wonder if there's a channel called that. It sounds familiar. Motovlogging or Motovlogger. Yeah, hopefully his recommendation is right, and it performs well at speeds. I know the Harley is definitely kind of pushing it when you're motovlogging because the bike is so loud versus, you know, these are definitely not as loud, so we'll see. So we'll wait for Brian to get here, and then we're going to go for a quick loop through Windermere, which is down kind of past the post office that I go to, go up to Winter Garden, and then probably hit the turnpike and head back. Just kind of winging it. Got a free Saturday evening. Miss Blockhead is at work. So just kind of riding around, getting to learn the bike. So far, so good. I'm liking it a lot. All right, in a bit. We're twins. All right, so Yamaha R3. It's a what, 2017, yeah?
16.
2016, yeah. Okay. So 2016 Yamaha R3. This is Brian. He lives right up the road. Actually, this is the guy that was driving by me in traffic that was like, I'll watch your videos. So I found out he lives right up the road. So this is Brian. He ended up buying an R3 not too long ago. Obviously, I got the R6 not too long ago, a couple days ago. So, and it's 2014, so that's the differences between them. It's crazy. The fairings do look a little different. I think I like your fairings more.
It just looks lighter.
It's like a different angle, kind of. Yeah, that's cool, man.
This is like a wave, mine is like triangled out.
I know I'm gonna get that bottom part probably like wrapped or something. I still gotta record a reveal video for it. Oh yeah, so keep this a secret still.
Yeah.
These videos aren't coming out for like another week and a half. I'm gonna have to get you to sign like a NDA, non-disclosure.
No, I wasn't aware of that. That's a secret.
Yeah, man. Show it out. Behind the scenes. So all right, cool. We're doing a route through Windermere. If at any point you need to like stop me, you know, just like flash your I-beams or come up beside me, let me know what's up. And we'll stop in like Winter Garden, grab some drinks or something, and it's just a chill Saturday ride. Yeah, let's go to the mobile. I'll fill up too, just in case. All right, so we got to get some gasolina. Yeah, I gotta get used to what the gas levels are like on this bike. I know on my iron, pretty much where it comes on. Although I'm sure I'd have like a fuel indicator. Like a low fuel light kind of thing. All right, that was the ride, guys. Hope you all enjoyed it. Skirt. Damn, that blinker, dude. It's gonna take so long to get used to that blinker. Oh, snap. What the hell is this? Premium. Expensive yum. First fill up on the R60. All right, who's in this limo, yo? Wonder how much this thing holds. Guess we're about to see. Oh, fuck. Keep it in. It's kind of crazy. If you think about it, you're riding a motorcycle, right? And you've got a full tank of extremely combustible, flammable liquid right under your chest. That's fun. Fun to think about. Nice ride, man. All right, you know what? So, reset. Trip van should be. Oh, shit. Just in case you guys want to run a limo. All right, dog. So, God, these, dude, I gotta do something about these mirrors. You'll see, I'll have to like lift my arm up. It's ridiculous. Ridiculous. You see, I have to like lift my arm up to see. I'm like, it's, these mirrors are terrible, man. I'm gonna get those bar end ones. Yeah, like kind of, you know how they are on my iron on the Harley? They're like down here. So I figure like those will probably be better bar ends. So hopefully this new mic is doing well. I guess we shall see. Hopefully we stop hitting fucking red lights. Run, run. Red light, red light, red light. You can go die. Oh, he's about to get a sorry. Sorry. La-da-da. La-da-da. So hard to like restrain yourself. Just hitting that. Because you know the power's there. You just can't take advantage of it because if you do, you'll be speeding. And speeding equals tickets. And too much speeding equals suspended license. Suspended license means no more Motovlog. So yeah, Brian, back meow, turns out he lives like just up the street. And shortly after that video, he actually ended up buying an R3. So, turns out, I just happen to be looking for an R6. Obviously, like, I'm not trying to do a huge group ride. Just because I'm trying to get used to the bike. God, blinker. Fuck you. So, yeah, since I'm trying to get used to the bike and all. Sorry. As I'm trying to get used to the bike, obviously, I'm not trying to ride, like, around a ton of people. Seeing as how Brian has an R3. Figured it'd be a cool little ride. There's a Harley bro up here. Harley dude. I saw a Harley dude. Woo, it's warm, yo. Kinda wonder how this mic does with the visor cracked also. Maybe this'll just be like a mic test video. We'll just let it be a mic test video. And you know what? If it turns out good, I will do a review of it. And I'll drop the link down in the description below. You sit so much. I mean, like I said, you guys are probably going to get real tired of me comparing it to the Harley. But you sit so much higher. Oh, pulling up beside another biker. Let's talk some Harley talk. What up, man? It's a nice bike, sir.
Hey, it's nice. Thank you. Like yours.
Got the 110. I have an iron, an 883.
Okay.
Ed, how do you like it?
I just have a GSXR and whatnot. It's probably like a sport bike.
Yeah.
And I don't have the downshift to go.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous.
Dude, they're way more comfy than sitting on this thing, you know?
Yeah, well, absolutely.
It's a nice ride, man. Super clean, too.
Yeah,
Yeah, I like your rims. They're the same color as mine, kinda. Yeah. What is it? Stock exhaust on there?
Yeah.
Really? Sounds good for stock. Cool, man.
Yeah. What year's yours?
2014.
Okay.
Yeah, R6.
Let's go.
All right, man. Ride safe, sir. Cool, man. It's a nice looking bike. See, I wish I had a spam card at this point. Like, God, I really need to do those. Whenever I would say whenever I get home today, I would do them. But no promises, because I got kind of a busy day after this whole ride. So after this, I have to go home, clean the house. After I clean the house, that's gonna take a while, man. It's a mess. This Blockhead and I have been slacking lately on cleaning it. But yeah, after that, I gotta run up and see if I can do some computer repair on some computer stuff. We'll see how that goes. Yeah, I mean, that's kind of a drive, so that's gonna take up most of the evening. But I would say I would totally design some Blockhead spam cards to hand out in traffic, but I don't know if I'll be able to. It's so funny, man, like whenever you're riding on the Harley, you know, you're a lot lower. Well, the perspective of this one, you know, you're setting up a lot more. So I'm seeing things that I've never normally, like, I wouldn't normally see. Like, I couldn't see over that wall beforehand because I was so much further down. Like, my perspective was a lot lower. So it's just funny. Like, I've rode this route a little bit, and it's just, it looks a little different from a higher perspective. Oh, shit. That's a raccoon. Dude. Crazy wildlife out here in Windermere. You don't need to be crossing the road, raccoon. You're gonna get hit, son. So I guess since no real dedicated subject to this vlog, just kind of talking about whatever we want, yo. Video did go up today, like I was saying, that goes over basically like not limiting myself with the vlogs, and thus far has gotten an awesome, awesome response. So to that, I have to say thank you guys, as always. Definitely always thanking you guys. That's because y'all are awesome. So thank you for being awesome. So yeah, like one of the comments that actually really kind of stuck with me, and I'm gonna wait till I'm off this bumpy road to talk. Yeah, one of the comments that kind of really stuck with me was because I was talking about videos that are longer. Right, and who knows, this might be a longer video unless I decide to get crafty with the editing and just chop a lot of it out and not show you guys, because we're going for a longer ride today, yo. But one of the comments that really stuck with me was this one person that was basically commenting in response to me talking about long videos, or the videos being longer, and they said, they were like, whenever I see a Blockhead video that's over 22 minutes, I pour myself a cup of coffee and I sit down and I prepare for a great start to the day. Yeah, I'm paraphrasing, it's not like an exact quote, but something along those lines. Which, dude, that's like so cool. Like, I don't know, making these videos, I mean, I guess it does make sense, because I kind of do the same thing whenever I wake up in the morning and I'm looking at who of my subscribers has uploaded. God, dude, lean angle on this thing is so much better. So yeah, like when I'm looking at what of my subscribers has uploaded, I'm like, okay, cool, you know, like these guys have uploaded videos, that's awesome, because, you know, like the people that I'm subscribed to, I enjoy their videos. Except one. There's one person that I'm subscribed to that I really just, I don't know why I'm still subscribed to them, to be honest, but whenever they upload, I just kind of skip right over their videos. And I think a lot of it's based on maybe like the title, but it just really, that Motovlogger really grinds my gears, and you guys probably know exactly who I'm talking about, because I haven't mentioned names in the past, and you guys have totally guessed who it is. God, it's such a nice day to ride. I gotta get some of those shorty shifter levers. Brian actually just installed like a little short lever on his clutch side. I think it's nice. This car is making us go slow. Sada, la da da. La da da, la da da da, la da 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 da. Name that song. God, blinker. Remember the blinker. Couple runners. That means I can't speed, because I don't want to blow them off the road by all this raw power. What's up? Oh, is there a guy at the little guard check this time? Man, guess it is the weekend. This shit's packed up. I'll just tell this guy we're turning around. I'll tell this guy we're here to put our boats in the water. I guess he doesn't want us to say anything. Boats, boats, boats! I've totally done the boats, boats, boats thing previously. Whoever posted up first, what that's from, gets a free Blockhead sticker. I've totally got to get more Blockhead stickers. Slaughter. Slaughter. La-da-da. Oh, pull over real quick, make sure B-rye is doing all good. B-rye, we got to get you a GoPro, bro. A GoPro, bro. So you can record some and be doing some commentary. I caught back up with you guys. I'm gonna win. Doing all right? So far, so good. We got a little ways to go. This is a real nice road right here. Super smooth, kind of windy. Huh?
No road damage.
Yeah. Dude, it's a perfect road. Yeah. All the roads from here to like 50, like real good stuff. I mean, real good. Real good. Yep. Word.
Me gusta.
Me gusta. Dude, that intro is so catchy, man. It's just, it makes you want to dance.
I don't even like watching my YouTube videos, all the ones that I watch of everybody. But every time she hears that song, she starts singing it in the room. She starts going crazy.
Who, your wife?
Huh?
Your wife?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome. Yeah. Gotta throw a...
I'm like, yeah, that's basic.
Yeah. Me gusta. Yo, you see that raccoon?
Yeah.
What the hell?
Out, of
out in the freaking middle of like the broad day trying to cross the street. So I'd be like, you gotta go to a crosswalk, raccoon. What are you doing?
And the raccoon, I guess, is stopping right by the raccoon. The raccoon ran the other way instead.
Oh, okay, he didn't cross the street?
Yeah, he didn't cross
the street. Like it's a bad joke. Like, why did the raccoon cross the road? To get to the chicken on the other side of the road. That's why he was gonna go eat the chicken. All right, man. Onward. I didn't even think about that joke. Why did the raccoon cross the road to eat the chicken on the other side? Left. Oh shit. Don't hit me with your boat, bro. You're good. You're good, bruv. Me gusta. Great, now I got the song in my head. Thanks, Baker.
Holy fuck.